In a world moving faster and further into the realm of technology and urbanization, we rarely get the chance to stop and smell the flowers. But if we did, we would feel the healing and calming properties of nature.
Did you know that fragrance molecules from different plants can be detected by receptors in the nose and converted into electrical impulses that get sent to the brain at different frequencies? These frequencies are organized into separate classes named after the letters of the Greek alphabet, and they control various cognitive functions such as alertness, calmness, and drowsiness. A concentrated source of plant fragrance is essential oils. These contain compounds known as terpenes, which affect the brain when inhaled. For example, the fragrance of mint increases the activity of the alpha class of brainwaves, boosting our alertness, while lavender, on the other hand, increases the activity of theta brainwaves, making you calmer and drowsier. Plant scientists found that when mothers and newborns took lavender baths, newborns cried less and their mothers smiled more.
However, plants do not need to be highly concentrated into essential oils for us to experience their therapeutic effects. Hydrosols, such as rose water, or even fresh flowers, can positively affect our mental state.
In one study, some plant scientists wanted to find out the effect that a species of rose known as the wishing rose had on the brain. The first thing they did was perform a POMS test, which is a questionnaire designed by psychologists to assess the mental state of a person. When subjects were in the presence of the wishing rose, the answers they gave showed that the rose had a sedative effect on the subjects. This was then followed up by another test that measured the parasympathetic nerve activity of the subjects, which is high when subjects are calm. So the scientists prepared four samples: whole wishing roses and wishing rose petals, which could both be smelt and seen; a blind, which is a rose but covered so that it can only be smelt and not seen; and finally, they prepared a control, which could be smelt but not seen, in this case, plain water. For the blind sample, an increase in parasympathetic nerve activity was detected, indicating the rose's sedative effect as expected. However, for the whole flowers and the petals, the sedative effect strangely seemed to decrease. The scientists then recalled another pink flower known as the petunia hybrida, whose color was found to uplift subjects and make them feel more energized. Based on this, the scientists concluded that it was the energizing pink color of the wishing rose that neutralized the calming effect of its fragrance. Isn't it interesting that according to the psychological POMS test, a rose's scent and appearance calms people down, but according to the physiological parasympathetic nerve activity, the rose's scent and appearance have two completely different yet both still equally positive effects? What more is there waiting to be discovered in the plant world of colors and smells? Clearly, plants have an impressive range of miraculous healing powers just waiting to be discovered. With mental health diseases on the rise as our modern world continues to transform at breakneck speed, we need to realize, appreciate, and explore the power of plants in therapy and in our daily well-being. I believe we need to take a step forward and go back to nature.